Hello, this is N7LMV, Jerry. What we're going to do is we're going to discuss the Echolink program and the screens that are available when you're running the Echolink program. If you want to run Echolink, go to www.echolink.org and you can download the program if you're a valid amateur radio operator. You'll also have to validate your call sign, but that will be for you to read the instructions when you're on that particular web page. Okay, there are 11 different sections of the Echolink screen, and I'll describe what each of them are, and then there will be five other little sections that you can view when you're looking at the Echolink screen. Right now we're in the index view. Index view is found down here. This is the index view. And that will be the view that we're going to be running for the time being. Okay. The first section of the screen is the very top section, which is in blue, and it will say Echolink and your call sign. And by the way, I'm running this in normal user mode, not sysdop mode. Okay, so it will say Echolink-N7LMV. That's one portion of the screen. The second portion of the screen has six little names: File, Edit, Station, Tools, View, and Help. Let's go over these. Okay, in the File section, you click on File. Let's zoom in real quick so you can see that. Okay, and we'll click on File. In the File section, you will have Print, Print Preview, Print Setup, Profiles, and Exit. Okay, the next section is the Edit section. You have Undo or Control Z, Cut, Control X, Copy, Control C, Paste, Control V, and Delete, your delete key. Okay, Station. This is your Transmit, which is your space bar. Connect, Connect To, Connect to Test Server, Reconnect, Disconnect, Request Version, Info, Find, Refresh List. Okay, so we'll go to the next one, which is Tools. This is going to be where you're at the most for setting up things. Okay, the first one is Alarms. If you click on Alarms, you're going to see a box open up, and it's going to have all the people that you added to your alarm list, such as I got KB4SVP-L, VK2, TRL-L, and the list goes on and on. I got like 90, maybe even 100 or more in there. Okay, so when we're done looking at that, we'll click the red X, and we'll go back to Tools, and then you can list yourself as busy. Alt B would be it. Okay, that way no one can bother you. The next is Setup. Setup is the most important area. You click on Setup and a new box will open up with six tabs. Okay, the first tab is My Station. And of course, I'm a single user, meaning I'm using my computer. Okay. Now, when you installed Echolink onto your computer, it took a whole bunch of information from you, such as your call sign, your password, your name, your location, and your email address. Okay. The next tab is your servers. And basically, I just use the default, which is like server.echolink.org. Okay. The next is your proxy. Now, this is fun Okay, I'm going to do this here, and I'm going to show you how you can do proxies if you're having problems setting up your firewall. Okay, now, if you have your firewall set up through your router, okay, there's no need to set up a proxy. But let's say you're having issues, okay? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to proxy, and I'm going to go to choose a public proxy. Now, if you're not having any firewall issues, just stay with Direct Connect. But we're going to choose a public proxy for this demo. We're going to refresh the list. It's loading the public proxy list. Okay. So now when it's all done, you're going to go to this little tiny arrow and you're going to click it down. Now, if you're in the United States, try to use a United States proxy. And there's many. Now, here we see that KB8UVN has two proxies listed. He probably has a whole bunch more. Number 048, number 037, and you can scroll down and you can find another US. There's a number 21. And just pick one that looks nice. There's a number 02. Now here's another one, a WA5CKF. And then we can continue on and just find one that looks comfortable to you. Now, when you do use a public proxy, each of them might have different time limits. Let's pick K0OG. So we're going to pick K0OG. And he's from Rolla, Missouri. And he says no links or repeaters. And he has his timer set for 60 minutes timeout. So after 60 minutes, you'll probably get disconnected. So we're just going to say, okay, we're going to click that. Okay, the screen will disappear, and you will see that it's going to refresh the list. It's contacting the proxy. It's trying the IP address. It's going to fetch the data, and the list will reappear. So it takes just a moment. Let's see what happens. It's trying still. And if you don't have any luck with this particular proxy, we can always reconnect. Well, it says it's fetching the data, so that's a good thing. And there it is. Your list comes back to normal, just as if you were on a Direct Connect. That is how you connect to a proxy. Well, I'm going to go back to a regular Direct Connect. So I'm going to go back to proxy. I'm going to go Direct Connect, no proxy. I'm going to go OK. Now, keep in mind, even though you went through a proxy, your call sign did not change. But we're going to go back to Direct Connect, no proxy. And it will refresh real fast, a lot faster than if we were going through Rolla. It's trying, it's fetching the data, the information is there. Quicker than before. Alright, so that's how you set up a proxy. Okay, we're going to go back to setup because we're not done there. Okay, so now the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to go to timing. Okay, I make my connect attempt at 30 seconds. Okay, I put my timeout time limit or my transmit time limit at 150 seconds, which equals 2 minutes and 30 seconds. What that does is when you're in the transmit mode, when you get very close to 2 minutes and 30 seconds being left on your talk time, a little timer is going to come down here and it will say timeout timer in 30 seconds and it will count down. Once it hits zero, your transmission will stop. Okay? So I use that for a particular repeater. The next item is your receive time limit. I leave that at 0. And I leave my inactivity timeout at 0. And the reason why is if you don't receive something in the set time that you put here in seconds, let's say I put 150, if I don't receive something in 2 minutes and 30 seconds, I'll probably get disconnected. And the same thing with down here. I leave my receive hang time at 1,200 milliseconds. Okay, next item. This is very important. Okay, this is your input device and your output device. Since I'm using a USB headphone set, I make sure that that's selected. That way I can hear people and I can talk to people. Okay, I leave my open in full duplex checked, and that's all you need there. Okay, performance is nothing. I don't use performance. Now, if people are saying that you're sounding sluggish, you can probably adjust this here higher or lower, and it will prevent a little bit of sluggishness with your audio. Okay, we're all done with that particular area. Okay, now we're going to go back to tools, and we're going to go to preferences. Preferences is another area that you're going to spend a lot of time in. There's 4 tabs in preferences. Okay, on the first one, which is lists, this is what's listed here. You're going to update your station list automatically, and that will be every 300 seconds. It will refresh that list. You want to put a check mark even while connected. Okay, these are the items that you want shown in your index view. That's this down here where we're at right now. You want repeaters, links, users, conferences, servers. You want them to show when they're busy and when they're free. For example, if I did not check station busy, then 4F2CDD-R would not be shown on the list. But since I have stations busy checked, it will show. And the same with station free. Okay? Now, this little box here, show alarms and pop-up window. If you have that checked, anything that's in your alarms list will pop up in a new box when the station that you have in your favorites comes on or leaves. Okay? Restore window size and position on startup. I have that checked. Show icons in pull down menus. That's good. All right, the next box is connection. Connections. Now, this is very important for certain people that don't want to be bothered when they're connected to other stations. And in connections, I allow conferences. And when you put a check mark in that for the first time, it's going to say, well, we hope that you have a very fast, or you have a fast internet connection such as DSL, and most people do, so just click yes. Then you can change your limit to 4, 2, 3, 10 other stations to connect up to you. Okay, put a check mark in update location entry with status. Put a check mark in station list to all stations. I do not allow multi-conferencing. So if I connect up to a conference server or someone that's acting as a conference server and there's more than 2 or 3 people, other people will not be allowed to connect up to me because I will be listed as busy. Okay? In the location description, I put my location, Chihuahua, when I'm free, and Chihuahua when I'm busy. I like to put a check mark in show name of connected conference. So like if I'm connected to KB4SVP-L, in this area it will say that I am connected to KB4SVP-L. Okay. Now, since I had that check mark in show, let's go back to list. Show alarms in pop-up window, since I had that check mark in there, this alarm log came up and told me that my friend Bob is off and my friend Gail is off. So that's what that's all about. Okay, so going back to connections. Okay, this PTT control, that's the push to talk control. If you click on that, a new box is going to open and you get to choose from this little, once you put in a check in the keyboard key, you get to check which key that you want to key the transmission, the Echolink program. You can have left control key, right control key, number pad plus, number pad enter. You can have space bar. I like to use the left control key. And you can have momentary checked. Or you can use the middle mouse button, whichever you want. Once you're satisfied with your selection, click OK. Okay. Station information. You can edit your station information. This is what's going to show up in this window over here. And you can edit it. And I got mine KB6DOW-L and N7LMV Creel Chihuahua Mexico listed. Once you're satisfied with what you want shown up here in this area, click OK. Okay. I like to also have show alert when doubling checked. Let's say you're connected to a conference server and people are transmitting at random and you decide, oh, I think I got time to transmit, and you go up here and you either push your control, your left control key, or you press the little lightning bolt. It will say, if you're doubling down here in this text message, it will say doubling with KB4SVP-L or whatever. Once that's all done, you're all done with the connections. Let's go to security. Security. Okay, security says accept connects from repeaters, links, users, and conferences. Now, if you only want specific call signs to connect to you, such as KB6YYT or K6FN, then you would want to put a check mark in there, and you would add new, and you would put in their call sign K6FN, and you would go okay. So that's that. You can go okay. Let's go back here to tools. Let's go to preferences. Let's go back to security. Okay, if you don't want someone to connect up to you, you can always say deny calls from these call, add the new call sign, and you can type in KB6YYT, okay, and then go okay. Now, keep in mind, we just told the computer Echolink program not to accept connects from K6FN or KB6YYT. Well, they're my buddies, so I do want to have them. But I basically just leave it alone and remove and remove and just leave everything alone. Okay? We're going to go to signals. Okay? People go, what is signals? Okay. Well, when someone connects to you, the default would be dink dink, and the same with disconnected. It'll go dink dink. And if somebody connects to, comes in on the alarms, it'll go delete. And let's see, over, basically none. Text messaging. If you are not paying attention to your text message area because you're watching the screen or listening to something else, you can always say, oh, I want to have, whenever someone sends a text, a little noise to be made. And once you got that done, then you can just click default, or you can make custom. And custom, you can make it any wave sound that you want. It could be a mooing cow. It could be a fire truck. It could be a fire whistle, a police car, a quack, quack, whatever. But default is fine. And you're all done with the preferences. Okay, so The next thing in tools is adjust sound audio. Now this here is very nice to have. Let's say the audio that you're hearing from a connected station is very low. That means you need to have the playback set, which will open up a new window, okay? And it will be your volume. And I basically have it right about there, and that would be fine, okay? And we'll go okay. Okay, now let's say somebody says, "Hey Jerry, your audio is very low." Well, that means that your recording, the thing that's actually recording your voice, needs to be adjusted. So you go to recordings and you adjust your mic gain here. And you can even go advanced and add 1 plus AGC. That boosts it quite a bit. Once you get that set, then you're done. And you can close out that. Okay, under tools again. We won't play sound file. If you have recorded something, which I'll show you how to do shortly, you can open up the window and it will have whatever you recorded in the past, and you can play it back to other people on the connected node that you're connected to. We'll go cancel. The last thing is a very, very important thing. When you're setting up Echolink, you have to make sure that your TCP ports and your UDP ports are open. Now, the only way that you can check this is if you're not connected to anybody, such as I'm not connected to anyone. So I'm going to click on Firewall Router Test. A new box is going to open up, and it's going to say Running Firewall. Now, you want the TCP port to open up, and it said it passed. And your UDP 5198 and your UDP 5199 needs to pass to make your Echolink experience less stressful. If it does fail, that means you need to go into your router and open up, it's called port forwarding, those two UDP ports to this computer that you're running Echolink on, and open up UDP 5198 and 99. Okay, so we're all done with that. Okay, the next thing is going to be the view. Okay, I like to have toolbar showing, which is this, status bar, large fonts, and then you can go to connection status, and if you notice, we'll show you what your connection status is when you click on connection status, it's going to show you all the packets that were sent and received, okay? And there should be numbers in there. If it says 0000, you probably never had connected to anyone, okay? We're done with that. Go back to view, okay? You're going to go to station summary. When you connect on station summary, this is going to open up a little box, and it's going to show you all the repeaters. There's 1,954 free repeaters, 157 busy repeaters, which equals a total of 2,111 total repeaters. There are 1,600 free links, 592 busy links, giving us a total of 2,192 total links. Okay, users, there's 602 free users, 175 busy users, with a total of 777. And the same goes with conference servers. Okay, so it totals it all up, and it says that there is a total of 5,304 total stations. Okay, in this box, 2,412 are from the US of A, 404 from Japan, 236 from Germany, etc., etc. Okay, and it just changed, which is fine. It will always change. Every 300 milliseconds on my computer, or 300 seconds, it will get a refresh. Okay, so we're going to close that out. Okay, alarm log. Okay, I've made it go away, and I can make it come back. Okay, this is the alarm log. Okay, view. Okay, server message. Let's find out what that is. Okay, the following information was returned by the remote server, and it says that I'm using Echolink server version 2.5.99997, and it's Echo EC2 Herndon, Virginia. Okay, very good. Okay, let's go back to view again. All right, system log. This shows all the things that you did with Echolink. How many times you started it up, how many times you brought it down, who are you connected to, who are you disconnected to, who are connected to you, and it goes until you clear this screen. And as you can see, just a moment ago I was talking to Mark, W6MRK, and it gives his name, gives his node number, gives his IP address. Okay, so we're going to close that out. Okay, and we go back to view, and we'll go to call sign log. We'll view, and it shows all the call signs that I spoke to, who they are, what conference, and you can clear it or you can close it. I like to just close it and keep my log open. Okay, help. Let's go to help, content, search, index, tip of the day, Echolink website, call sign validation, help on the web. This is where you go to upgrade your Echolink version, and about Echolink, and it says, like I said, I'm using Echolink version 2.0.908, and that's all right, so we're good. All right, now we're going to go down to the next level, which is level 3, and you'll have your transmit, and that will only be if you're connected to somebody. And now I'm connected to Ann. Ann just connected to me. So I'm going to click on transmit. Hello, Ann. I'm doing a video, and now you are part of the video. How are things going with you? I'm going to keep it short, but hey, you get to be a part of the video. Woohoo! Back to you, young lady. So since she connected to me, I don't know if you'll hear her. I did transmit to her. But she's not responding. Okay, I'm going to push it down again. Hello, Ann. Are you hearing me? Because I'm not hearing you. I was hoping that you would want to be a part of this video real quick. Since I was just on the part of using the lightning bolt to show how to transmit. And so since you're here, I'm going to untransmit and you can talk. KA6AYJ and 7LMV. We'll see if she responds. Okay, she's not responding, so I'm going to disconnect from her. And that's where we go to the little red link. Well, she disconnected for me. So anyways, okay, this next one is to connect. So let's say you were to go to, we'll say 4F2CDD. He's busy, so we won't be able to get him. So let's go to 4F2RV-R. Now, I don't know where he's at. Once you highlight that, and we'll discuss the screen here section next after we're done with all of these fun little icons. Since we highlighted them, it gives us a green connect. So if I was to connect on that, push that button, it would connect me to him. But we won't connect. Okay, the next is to disconnect. So like Ann wasn't talking, so I would have disconnected. Okay, the next is the cut tool. So let's say I wanted to cut that and paste it somewhere else. I could cut and paste. Okay, the next is copy. So I could copy that call sign, KF4F2RV. I could copy that and I could paste it to Notebook, Word, whatever. Okay, and then I can go here to paste and paste it to wherever I need to. And then I can refresh my nodes list. So I'm going to click on that and refresh. It's saying trying. It's fetching the data and it just refreshed. Okay. The next is the info. Okay. Now we have already seen this here before. So when we click on this here, it's just a shortcut and it will bring up that station information. 4F2RV-R. His IP address is 98.248.123.195. And he is using Comcast.net. Okay, so we're okay. The next that we're going to do is find. Let's say we wanted to find KA6. W6MRK. W6MRK. Now this here will save us time from scrolling down this list to find this particular person. So what the computer program will do is find it automatically. So this little thing is going down and it brings me down to W6MRK. Okay. If I wanted to find KA6AYJ, I can always just do that and it will find her. And she's in Traverse City, Michigan, and her name is Ann. Okay? So, we're done with the binoculars to find. Okay? Let's say we wanted to add someone special to our favorites list. We will click on the bell. We will click on Add New. And we'll say W7ASC dash R. That will add the Arizona Science Center to my favorites list, and I'll go OK. Now this here is the setup button. Okay, you click this, it's like going into tools and then setup. So we've already gone through all of that. It's just a quick little click to get you to this screen, and we're all done with it. Okay. The next one is preferences. Okay, we click that, and it brings up the same thing as if we were to go to tools and preferences. And we've already gone through all of these. It's just a quick icon to get you there. Okay, the next thing is to list you as busy, so it's depressed. And you can see it's depressed, so that puts me as busy, so nobody will connect up to me. Okay, the bookshelf is the statistics. Okay, we've already seen this, but I'm going to click on it so you know what it does. It brings out your connection status, how many packets in, how many packets out. Okay, the next one is information, the station summary, and that again will tell you how many repeaters are free and busy, how many links are free and busy, etc., etc. Okay. The next item is the play item. Let's say you're connected to somebody and you want to play an audio file, such as you took an audio recording from them to see how it sounded or how they sound. The next is your stop button, your pause button, your record button. And that will only work when you're connected to a node. Your print button and your help button. Okay. All right, now we're going to get down to this screen. And this is in index view. We'll go over this here in a moment in a different view. Okay. We're going to go to the very top. This screen is in alphabetical numerical order. Okay, and what that means is it lists all the repeaters first, this is your repeater icons. Now, what is a repeater? It's a station acting as a repeater or a station connected to a repeater. And then the next area, like I say, it's listed in numerical order, so anything with a number comes first, and then it goes A, and then it will go B, C, D, and you'll see that as we scroll down the list. So there's now AF, AH, AP, and it will show all the repeaters. Okay, we're gonna scroll down by using this little scroller here, and we're gonna scroll down until we get to the link section. Okay, so it will scroll to the link section, and I'll give you an idea of where the break is. Okay, so the last station listed as repeaters in this refresh was Zulu Uniform 9 Delta Charlie Mike Dash R. Now we're in the link stations, and link stations are stations that are either linked to a radio or to a repeater. And like I say, it goes in numerical order, so 2 Delta 0 India Charlie Mike, or I'm sorry, India Oscar Mike Dash L. And you're going, well, what is all the rest of the information that's listed on the screen? Well, as far as 2 Delta 0 India Oscar Mike Dash L, he is on. He's not busy, so that means you can connect to him. If he's busy, you probably won't be able to connect to him. Their time, he's in conference with AB9RH-L. Or it will say his location. It will say, oh, I'm in Petersburg, or I'm in St. Louis, Missouri, or whatever. Okay, the next area is going to be his node number, 9265. Am I right? Yep, I'm right. Okay, so he's been on Echolink for a long, long time because he's only got a four-digit number. You're going, well, what's the node number have to do with being on the list? Well, if you're running HT and you're connected to a repeater that has Echolink on it, it might allow you to connect up to this particular node. And the only way that you can do it is by entering in his node number, 9265. Okay, next on the list is going to be the people area. Okay, so we'll scroll down until we start seeing people. And you'll know that very quick-like, because you'll see a picture of a person. Okay, so now these are people that are on their computers or on their iPhones or their mobile devices. And I see that WS6GTO is on. I'm going to try to connect up to him, so let's find him. WS6GTO. I want to talk to him, so let's go find him, and I'm going to connect up to him and see if we can talk. So I double click on him, and I go up to connect. I'm connecting, and it says route not available. So he must be on a phone or something. Okay, so anyways, even though it says he's on, and of course his computer says that it's 0629 in Victorville, California, I don't think that's true. And then of course it says his node number, and of course his is a six-digit node number, so he's pretty new to Echolink. Okay, the next section, let's move this bad boy down here, is going to be the conference servers. Okay, so we'll scroll down till we get to the conference servers, and again they're listed in numerical alphabetical order. Okay, conferences are areas where a group of people, I mean lots of people, gather, like 10 watts. And notice that it has an asterisk, 10 watts asterisk. Anything that is a conference server node always has an asterisk. And it says that there are 37 people in this particular node. Okay, and this is also where you go to check and see if your audio is good or bad, and if your system is working. It's called echo test, asterisk echo test asterisk, or star echo test. So let's say I wanted to connect up to that. I click on it once, I go up here and I connect up, and it says down here connected. Okay, when it's all ready for me to transmit, I go up here to the transmit bar, or I can hit my control key, and I go N7LMV. Now, when I'm transmitting, this audio bar will move, and it will say that I'm transmitting. It will say who I'm connected to, and it will say if my levels are good. So, now I'm done, and now I'm going to play back my transmission. So, I unclick the lightning bolt. It will now play it back. Okay, now that that's taken care of. Okay, so now we went over the repeaters, the links, the computers, and the conferences. Okay, one other thing in conferencing. You'll see, like, their name, their on, their time, their conference or their location. And you'll see in parentheses, like this says 46/500. That means that there are, at the time, 46 people in this conference, and it can handle up to 500 people. Okay, now we're going to go to the other portion of the Echolink window, and that's this area. When you're connected to somebody, it's going to say who you're connected to, and it says that I am connected to the conference audio test server, and there are 15 people right now using it. It will say my name, my call sign, if that's what I had in the profile, and it will give you what the server is used for. Okay, so we're all done with that. So now I'm going to disconnect from the audio test server, and I go here to the red link, and I disconnect, and I will close out this because we don't need him anymore. And let's see, now it says I'm not in QSO. The last connection that I was with was Echo Test. Okay, the next area is this area. This is your received text area. Anyone typing text to the node that you're connected to will be viewed here. And if you wanted to send text, you just click in this area and you type in what text that you want. You can hit enter or send, and it will show up here, and all viewers connected to the node that you're connected to will see that information. Okay, now we're going back to this area right here, and we're going to connect back up to Echo Test. And we'll highlight it one more time. We'll connect up to it by going up to the green link. And this here is going to show you. Okay, it says who I'm connected to. It shows their IP address. And of course, you did see with the bar moving when the server was talking to me. And that bar will also move when I go up to transmit. And I transmit. And you'll see the bar moving. And then I'm done transmitting. And when it plays it back, you'll see it moving again. Well, I disconnected. So That won't happen. Okay, there's another area. We'll go back to echo test and connect up to it again, because there's another area that I need to show you, and that's this area down here. First off, it says that you're ready to use the Echolink software, but there's a whole bunch of little areas down here, and people go, what's going on? What's going on? What's going on with these? So let's connect back up to Echo Test. Echo Test is the excellent place to connect to, because you're not bothering nobody. It's just you and Echo Test. So let's reconnect up to Echo Test, and we'll see what this is all about. Okay. Okay, it says that we were connected, and there was also another thing that was saying receiving. This section right here will show any DTMF, that's dual tone multi-frequency tones, that are being received by the Echolink program. Okay, I'm going to transmit, and you'll see another item come up here. So let's transmit. It says TX down here, and you will see my bar moving, and now we're going to stop transmitting, not disconnect this time. Now it says, okay, you seen how that RX was there. Okay, so that was saying that it was receiving. Okay, now we're all done with Echo Test. Oh, and by the way, we're going to type in a text here. We're going to go hello, H-E-L-L-O. You put your cruiser there, and you send, and it will say your call sign hello. Like, Echo Test server doesn't recognize that, but it just to show you how to do it, I'll say hello again, H-E-L-L-O. AGN. You can either hit enter or you can press send, and there it goes. Okay, so now we're going to disconnect from Echolink by going up to the red link. Okay, so now we've viewed quite a bit of the Echolink items that are there. Now we're going to go to Explorer View. Explorer View. Everybody goes, what in the heck is Explorer View? Watch the screen change. Okay, the screen changes. Now, keep in mind, this line is still here, Echolink N7LMV, your file, edit, station tools, and your little icons are all there. The only thing that changes is your window right here. Okay, so in the first box, you'll see locations, node types, alarms, new, and favorites. Let's go to locations. We're going to click on the plus button. Let me zoom in here. Oh, let's go zoom. Let's see if it worked. Okay. It says that there are 18 in Africa. There's 810 in Asia, and so on. Okay. Let's get out of zoom and we'll show you what that's all about. Okay. So we're going to click on the plus again in Africa. Let's zoom in. Whoops, sorry about that. And you can see that it says Mozambique, Namibia, South Africa. And let's click on South Africa. Okay. When I clicked on South Africa, these are all the people in South Africa that are using the Echolink. And that will be on your right-hand side screen. Now, any of these here that are showing, you can click on them and double-click. I would put it on the link or the repeater or the person. I wouldn't put it on their call sign. I would put it actually on them that you want. So let's say I want to connect up to ZS5 PMB-repeater. I put my cruiser on it and I double click. And now I'm connected to it. See how it says connected to South Africa? And it says welcome to the All-Star node, Echolink node, their node number, and that it's linked. Okay, you want to disconnect from them, just go over here to the disconnect. Okay, now you can do this here for whatever you want. We can go North America, and we can go to the United States, and you can go to the call area. Let's say I want to find KB4SVP. So I double click on that, and here's everybody that's listed as fours. Let's move this out of the way. And I can find KB4SVP-L, and there it is. There's KB4SVP-L. And all I got to do is double click on them. Okay, that's how you use that. All right, so we're all done with this. So let's close out, let's close out. Okay, the next thing is node types. Okay, we're going to click on that. You can list all the conferences, all the links, all the repeaters, all the users. Okay, so let's say I wanted to see all the users. I just click on that. And these are all the users. These are people that are on their computer or on their mobile devices. That's the way I don't have to go through the index view and scroll to the very bottom. And again, it does it in numerical, alphabetical order. Okay? So that's a quick way of finding all the users. Okay? So let's make that small. Okay? Let's say I've added people to my alarms. And I have 103. I click on alarms, and this here shows me all of my friends. So like if I wanted to connect up to KB4SVP, I'll connect up to KB4SVP. And just double click, okay? When I get connected, it says down here, connected to KB4SVP conference 1 of 25. It's in the United States, tells who he's going through. He's actually in Canada, this node here. He's with Eastlink in Canada. Okay, over here it says conference, our coffee shop, 2 of 25. It's my call sign, my name, and it tells the information about the node. Okay, now I want to disconnect. Okay, disconnect. Okay. Now, new is all the new people that just came in within the last 2 minutes. These are all the new people that came in within the last 2 minutes. And again, it does it in numeric alphabetical order. All right. That, now favorites. You can add people to favorites. You'll hear them saying, oh, there's favorites. Okay, so let's say I wanted to add people to favorites. Let's say I wanted to add my friend Chin to my favorites list. I put my cruiser and I press down on the left side and I drag it to my favorites. And now he's there. Let's say I wanted to add my friend Mike to my favorites. I put it on his call sign and I bring it over, and now there's two. So now if I wanted to have favorites, I got them. But they will always be in my alarm as well. Okay, now you're seeing the difference in colors. Okay, 9M2 Charlie Whiskey-L, my friend Chen in West Malaysia. He's busy. Okay, my friend Arnold, K3TEL, he's busy. Okay, my friend Bill, he's a link, he's not busy. He's in Manteca, California. And then anything that's grayed out, it will say they're off. So if it's really light, they're off. And your list can go on and on and on and on. All right, so that, my friends, is the basic understanding of the Echolink program. Thank you for watching, and Enjoy Echolink. Ciao.